The ability of fatty acids to interact with themselves is a really important concept when we start thinking about how the lipid bilayer forms, right? So you may remember from a previous biology class that when we talk about a lipid bilayer, we often talk about a polar head group with two fatty acid tails kind of hanging off, right? And we have these lipids that pack together tightly in one layer and then in a second layer. And this is how we compartmentalize things within a cell. Because on the outside, right, water can easily interact with the polar head groups, but water does not want to interact with our hydrocarbon tails because hydrocarbon tails are nonpolar. They only experience London dispersion forces, while water is polar, so they don't mix well. In this video, what I really want to focus in on is thinking about the interaction between these hydrocarbon tails within the inside part of the lipid bilayer. Right? When we show these, we commonly show them just as kind of like these long, skinny molecules attached to a polar head group. However, in reality, this is not always the case, and the nature of the fatty acid dictates how well these individual lipids, these individual fatty acids, actually interact with themselves. So let's think about the physical properties of fatty acids, especially their ability to interact with one another. So let's go ahead and compare a 16-carbon saturated fatty acid to an 18-carbon saturated fatty acid. So what we're really thinking about is which of these two have stronger intermolecular forces. And we're especially focusing in on the hydrocarbon tail, right? So this part of the fatty acid. We're going to ignore the polar head group for right now, and we're only thinking about the intermolecular forces that occur between the hydrocarbon tails. Okay, and I'm not going to draw both these all the way out, but they both adopt the same general shape, right? We have our carboxylic acid functional group followed by a bunch of carbons. So, right, I'm not going to draw it all out, but this is the hydrocarbon tail. So if we're thinking about a short fatty acid interacting with another short fatty acid, then focusing on this region, we know the only thing that's going to play a part here is London dispersion forces, because hydrocarbon tails are nonpolar. So we have London dispersion forces only, and you might remember that these dispersion forces get larger as the molecule gets bigger. So bigger molecule, bigger dispersion force. So what that should tell us is that as the chain length gets larger, there's going to be stronger London dispersion forces, meaning they're going to be able to interact more strongly. So if we're ranking these in terms of strength of intermolecular force, our 18-carbon saturated fatty acid is going to have stronger London dispersion forces than our 16-carbon. And if we have stronger London dispersion forces, that also means that we're going to have a higher melting temperature for the 18 carbon than the 16 carbon. Okay, and that's a really important idea when we think about the physical properties of lipid bilayers. But what happens as we add in double bonds? Well, as we've drawn unsaturated fatty acids up to this point, we've always shown the cis configuration of the double bond as part of this kind of line in our fatty acid. So we keep showing it as this kind of straight line. However, in reality, these cis double bonds in fatty acids actually cause the double bond to kink. So we no longer have this kind of straight line. Instead, now our unsaturated fatty acids adopt the structure where we have a kink in the backbone. And that's really important when we start thinking about how well these unsaturated fatty acids are able to interact with each other. So if we have one unsaturated fatty acid trying to interact with another one, we really have limited surface area, right? So we really only have this part of the fatty acid that's able to physically interact. The rest of it is too far away, so they can't physically interact through London dispersion forces. Consequently, this means that unsaturated fatty acids always have weaker intermolecular forces than saturated. And that plays a really important role in the function of the lipid bilayer. So in this class, we're not going to really get into the fluid dynamics of lipid bilayers. However, one really cool practical application of the ideas that we're talking about in this video come when you think about the differences between oils and fats. Okay, so oils, by definition, are fatty acids that are liquids under normal conditions, where fat is a fatty acid that's solid under normal conditions. Okay, so oils, say like olive oil, these are liquids under normal conditions because they contain a lot of unsaturated fatty acids, meaning that they melt easily. However, fats like butter or cheese or fat in meat, it contains a higher degree of saturated fatty acids, which is what makes it stay as a solid under normal conditions.